There is no poetry in suicide, and there is no poetry in cigarettes. Yet, so many poets break their lines with rats of triggers, break their lines with glyphs. So many poets break their necks below cliffs. Many find refuge in rifts. Many find rhymes in death and sing a little of a lullaby, a dwelling, a swimming in mourning. Whisper in each other's ears around writing tables their wills. There's no beauty in this. There's no poetry in this. Yet, when my grief lost anger, I lost my will. When I became no longer angry, my lungs became merely slaves to a rhythm, a routine. I no longer took breaths because I wanted to. I took breaths because if I did not, my grandmother's heart would be broken, and I cannot bear to break her multi-broken, seldom glued heart. In my tongue's honesty, I'll admit, my love seat is made for two, and I am not loveless, but loverless. And no matter how much I pack my joy in jars, soak it in salt water so it persists, my joy is stolen, stoned, bricked. I am blue and blued, and I bruise and scar myself, so I entertain it on my couch. Suicide, I let it in. Sometimes we talk, yes, maybe because I fall in love with those who have knives for teeth and onions for tongues. And maybe because of heartache or genetics or maturity lived too early, raised like a child with child or a child without childhood. Sometimes I cannot help but to wound my rhymes instead of my wrists. Still, there is no poetry in this. There is nothing but long nights melatonin, tubs turned beds, and mornings that promise me new beginnings and warning I owe myself. And a lot of baby, don't you let nobody steal your joy. Motherfuckers will try, but don't let them. Thank you, Miss Thing, who caught me crying behind my eyelids and held me like my mother did int. And all poetry's in this. Consolation, recourse, flesh in flesh. A woman's heavied with burdens, electric embrace. Unburdening my poetry. All poetry's in this. All poetry's in this. All poetry is in this.